Hello everyone, welcome back to another exciting edition of Clack It. Tonight we're celebrating Teachers Day.
It is actually the International Teachers Day that was first celebrated in 1962.
All right, so that's 5-6 years before you were born.
Kind of. Yeah, you like picking on me. But you know, teachers have been there all the time.
Yes.
And without teachers, you haven't been...
I won't be here, exactly. Honestly. I'll send this message to all the educators, including yourself, from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
So we're going to dedicate this episode to teachers, and we would say to Sir with love. Teachers' Day, also known as International Teachers' Day, was first celebrated in 1962 in India. The students celebrated the academician and vice president and later president of India, Dr. Radhakrishnan, on his birthday and commemorated 5th of October as Teachers' Day in his honor. Later, the UNESCO borrowed the idea. Established in 1994, it commemorates the signing of the 1966 UNESCO ILO recommendation concerning the status of teachers, which is a standard-setting instrument that addresses the status and situations of teachers around the world. What a great song. Now, this one was from the movie Hitchhiky, translated into English to Hiccup, a 2018 Indian Hindi language comedy drama film stars Brani Mukherjee as an aspiring teacher who was rejected by many schools because of her Tourette syndrome, assigned to teach students from a nearby slum, which was created by the government of India to fill a quota for the unprivileged students. So on this day, we would say to Sir with love.
Yeah.
These kids are a special breed.
Joseph.
Yeah.
There. Yeah.
Young and wild, as hard as the streets of London. As touching as a 16-year-old who knows all the answers.
You're not in trouble, are you?
No, sir. Nowadays, it's only for fools, isn't it?
If you wanted the sky, I would ride across the sky.
Sidney Poitier, in a role worthy of his Academy Award-winning talents, as the teacher who joins battle with the wildest set of rebels London ever produced.
What is the matter?
Those kids are devils incarnate, huh? I tried everything. Everything, but nothing. I tried.
Kids. Kids. That's it.
So sorry. It's...
To Sir with Love is a 1967 British drama, a film that deals with social and racial issues based on a 1959 autobiographical novel of the same name. It stars Sidney Poitier, the first black actor to win the Academy Awards for Best Actor for Lilies of the Fields, and that was in 1963. Also in the movie is singer Lulu making her first film, the film debut, and the film's title song, To Sir with Love, sung by Lulu, peaked at the top of the Billboard Hot 100 chart in the United States for 5 weeks in 1967. The movie ranked number 27 on the Entertainment Weekly, a list of the 50th best high school movies.
If you wanted the sky, I would ride across the sky and live.
Sidney Poitier and James Clavell wanted to do the film, but Columbia was reluctant. They agreed to make the film for small fees of $600,000 only, and the film proved to be a big hit when released by grossing $42 million. A made-for-television sequel to Sir With Love Part 2, and that was made in 1996, was released nearly three decades later with Boite reprising his starring role to Sir With Love. The other movie for today is entitled Lost in Space, a 1998 American science fiction adventure film directed by Stephen Hopkins and starring William Hart, Matt LeBlanc, and also Gary Oldman. The plot is adapted from the 1965 to 1968 CBS television series of the same name, itself inspired by the 1812 novel, The Swiss Family Robinson. I'm sure you know them. Several actors from the TV show make cameo appearances, which is really cool, and the film focuses on the Robinson's family who undertake a voyage to a nearby star system to begin large-scale immigration from Earth. But they're thrown, of course, by and must try to find their way back home.
T-minus 1 minute and counting.
Major, she's all yours.
Mission Control, this is Jupiter 1. The Robinsons are all tucked in. We are ready to fly.
The time has come.
Danger, Robinson! Danger!
You did this!
It could be thrown anywhere in the galaxy.
Anywhere but here.
Initiate.
We're lost, aren't we?
Their position is uncharted.
That's not one of ours.
I'm detecting motion behind you.
Their enemies are unknown.
Evil knows evil.
So my quarters are yours.
Why don't you just hang on to your joystick?
Warning! Warning!
Their survival is uncertain.
Give me an excuse to kill you.
Lost in Space received negative reviews from critics and grossed $136 million worldwide with an $80 million budget, so not bad. Now, I guess people liked it, but not the critics. However, big effort and a lot of work was made for the special effects, so how about we go behind the scenes to check this out.
Is 767. It may be a small account than you've heard speculated, but I believe it's still a record. And turning out 767 shots in 6 months still means that we are doing on average 3 to 4 shots a day, which is quite unheard of in sort of digital post terms. So it was an awful lot of work, and it was an awful lot of work in terms of complexity as well. It wasn't just one type of shot. We had all sorts of different types of shots. We had sequences like the Bubble Fighter, which are 90% CG. Almost the entire environment around the actors was put in post. All the live action were shots of Don West, played by Matt LeBlanc, against green screen in a small rig. After that, all the backgrounds were put in.
Thank you.
we're heading towards the weekend, let's check out the box office in Hollywood and Bollywood. We're going to start with Hollywood in a movie entitled Amsterdam. It's a 2022 period mystery comedy film written, directed, and produced by David O. Russell. The film features an ensemble cast that includes Kristen Bell, Margot Robbie, John David Washington, Chris Rock, Anya Taylor-Joy, Zoe Saldana, Mike Myers, Taylor Swift, Rami Malek, and the great Robert De Niro. Another movie is entitled Signs of Love, drama romance starring Dylan Penn. There's also Rosanna Arquette, and with them is Hopper Jack Penn. A third movie is entitled Tar, a psychological drama film starring Kate Blanchett. She plays the role of one of the greatest living composers, and first ever female chief conductor of a major German orchestra. The movie is really great, and you have to watch it, so let's just go to the next one that is entitled To Leslie, a drama film directed by Michael Morris and stars Andrea Rosenberg. This film will make you cry. Now, if you don't want to cry, let's laugh with The Crocodile Movie. It's a live-action animated musical comedy film. It's an adaptation of the children's story of the same name, and it's a prequel that is entitled The House on East 88th Street. The film stars Shawn Mendes, and with him is Javier Bardem. Moving from Hollywood to Bollywood, and the movie that is entitled Goodbye, an Indian-Hindi language film, comedy-drama film, stars Amitabh Bachchan. There's also with them Rashmika Mandanna in her Hindi film debut. There's also Nina Gupta in the movie. Another movie is entitled The Godfather, an Indian Telugu language political action film. It's a remake of the 2019 Malayalam film that is entitled Lucifer. The film stars Chiranjeevi, and also with them is Salman Khan. Another movie in Bollywood is Majamma, a comedy family drama with Madhuri Dixit playing the perfect mother. It's going to be in digital release only in Amazon Prime. Well, that's all for the weekend.
And since we talked about the Lost in Space movie, we'll now talk about the show, which has the same name, Lost in Space, which is an American science fiction streaming television series following the adventures of a family of space colonists whose ship veers off course. The series is a reboot of the 1965 series of the same name, inspired by the 1812 novel and the title, The Swiss Family Robinson. The film, or the show, is produced by a legendary television, Synthesis Entertainment, as well as Clickety Clack Productions and Applebox Entertainment. The show is written by Matt Sazama and Burke Sharpless, with Zach Estrin serving as the show runner.
Lost. No kidding. This is Will Robinson of the 24th Colonist Group. I'm the first human to discover evidence of an alien intelligence.
What is that?
It's okay.
Will!
He's with me.
Danger, Will Robinson.
Gently.
The show takes place in the year 2046, 2 years after an event threatens the survival of humanity itself. The Robinson family is selected for the 24th mission of the Result 24th Colonist Group, an interstellar spacecraft carrying selected families and civilians to colonize the Alpha Centauri planetary system.
We don't have to fight. It doesn't have to be this way.
As for the cast of this show, we have Molly Parker, Toby Steffens, Maxwell Jenkins, Taylor Russell, Mina Sandel, Ignacio Siracio, Parker Posey, and now let's check out more from this show.
Jesse, can you get that for me?
The show is rated on IMDb 7.3 and it has 3 seasons with 28 episodes in total. Each episode is about an hour long. The show was nominated for 3 Emmy Awards and won 5 awards in other competitions, in addition to 31 nominations in several other competitions.
I can't stop!
Hold on!
Yeah.
So I guess our common movie and TV show today is Lost in Space. But yeah. Before we get into that,
yes,
we talked about the Teacher's Day and the Sidney Poitier with the Sir to Sir with Love. Mm-hmm. I gotta say, just recently there was a documentary released in the movie theaters entitled Sidney by Denzel Washington, Halle Berry, Morgan Freeman, the family of Sidney Poitier, and the name of it is also Sidney.
Okay.
It just gives you a whole clear idea about his journey in movie making.
Well, if it has Denzel, then I'm all on board.
Definitely, you know? Definitely.
When is it coming out?
It already came out in the U.S., but not in Kuwait.
All right. I'll make sure to check it out.
So maybe you'll find it in one of the platforms.
Maybe.
And we're not going to say the name.
We're not going to say the name.
Lost in Space, it all started in 1960-something. Maybe okay. 1964, I think.
So 3 years before you were born.
Exactly. Kind of, yes.
Okay.
Mr. 2000-something. Okay, so
95.
The show started there, mm-hmm. and then they had the movie in 1998,
okay.
and then they had also the TV show that you talked about, the one in one of the platforms.
Yes.
So you haven't seen the original, right?
I have not seen the original.
The original was very popular.
Cool.
People loved it.
And doing sci-fi back then, it just really...
It was a big thing.
It was a big thing. Yeah.
And it was in color also, not a black and white. So
cool.
That was really cool. Now, you need to know that the whole idea thing came from Robinson family. Robinson family, you know, because they actually, he travels with his family, mm-hmm. and then they all get lost in one of these islands.
Right.
So the same thing happens. This is why it's called Lost in Space.
Lost in space.
Whole family gets lost in space.
Gets lost in space.
So what do you thought of the TV show of the, you know, 2018?
The new one that one came out. So I'll admit that I talked about a show that I haven't seen, but has been on my list, to watch list.
You haven't seen
it? I haven't seen it.
Oh, okay.
But it's been on my list. I checked the trailers when it came out first mm-hmm. in 2018, and I'm just looking forward to it. It has a few not known actors, but their acting capabilities are shown through the trailer.
Okay.
I can tell they can bring in the characters from those eras.
Well, the movie that was made in late 90s, it was with big actors. Matt LeBlanc was with them, by the way.
Oh,
from
really?
France. Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
But by the way, the movie for the critics sucked.
Oh, really?
But it wasn't that bad in the box office.
Critics didn't like it, but it performed well,
yeah.
So people gave it a chance.
It did generate profit for the producers.
It did generate profit.
So that's the good thing. Yeah, I think they said it's one of the, according to the critics, it's one of the lousiest remakes ever.
Wow.
It did, yeah. I think it was also nominated to, what they call it, the Raspberry?
Yeah. The
worst movies thing.
Yeah. There's a
the
thing.
Equivalent
yeah.
to the Oscars.
Yes.
So I saw the movie. It wasn't bad. Matt LeBlanc was still doing Friends when he did that movie, so that was also a big thing for him.
I think that's the only reason he got that role.
Maybe, I guess. Remember he was auditioning all the time in Friends?
Yep.
But we're
yep.
not talking about Friends today.
We're not talking about Friends
that
today.
That will be next Thursday.
In a few days.
So the whole idea of Robinson's family, you know, it was from the 19th century, as I said. It's about this family that is lost in space. They're not connected to anyone at all.
Mm.
And they have to find their way and to survive if they can ever come back to Earth. But we're not going to say what happens at the end.
Right. We're not going to give you spoilers. Just go watch.
So you said you haven't watched the TV show, but what about the movie?
Not even
the movie?
No. I just realized from that these are being remade.
You were enjoying your vacation.
I was enjoying my vacation.
You haven't been doing your homework, AJ.
I graduated, and I'm done with homework.
So there are two things that you have to watch. Sidney, the documentary.
Yes.
For Denzel Washington.
Yes, Denzel Washington.
Lost in Space, the TV show. I really recommend going to the original one, the one that was
compare,
made in the 60s.
To compare, yeah. Okay.
The one 2 years before I was born, as you said.
Three.
and then the movie, too.
Okay. Sounds good.
I guess that's the end of our show for today, right?
It is a wrap-up for our show. Join us next time so we can talk about more movies and TV shows.
Maybe friends.
Maybe friends.
Hopefully. Take care.